for your viewing pleasure today is a massive kit from the folks at Franzis. They sent this over for a full build-up, 1/3 scale. Look at my hand compared to that box. K-Code 289 Mustang V8 from 1965, as you can see it on there. It is an amazingly huge kit, very detailed, and we're going to build it all up today on the workshop. Now, bringing the camera down, that beautiful book is actually your assembly manual. And it's not just an assembly manual, it is an actual book, a big, heavy printed book. In the beginning, gives a gorgeous history of the Mustang. Lets you know all about the Mustang from back when it was created, designed. They talk about the engine, they get into modern Mustangs, and then towards the back they'll start talking about the engine and how it works, all the different styles of engines in the Mustang, including the 289 we're building. When you get to the back of the book is your assembly manual with beautiful schematic drawings, and when you're all done you can put this beautiful thing on a bookshelf and save it forever along with your model. Now let's start getting some parts out here, and there are a lot of parts to look at, so bear with me, but I always know it's important to show you everything that comes in the kit so that we don't have a bunch of questions and, was this included, was that included, was that not included, why didn't it have this, and you can actually see everything in the parts review. These are the lobes to the cam, individually placed on a metal rod that we'll see later. I love the plastic in this. It's very thick and heavy duty. This is not going to wear out like a lot of the cheaper ones. We've got a whole bunch of clear parts to look at. We've got part of the bottom of our cylinder heads there. We've got water pump housings, all in that nice lightly smoked plastic, but still more than clear enough to see through. It's a more of a, it almost feels like a vinyl because it's somewhat flexible, but very durable. We've even got a dipstick in this kit. That's awesome. We've got a fuel pump in two halves. We got the huge, look at that. I mean, it's just, it's massive, and it's like thick and big. Of course, 1/3 scale, of course, it has to be big, but we've got so much stuff in here. We've even got spark plug holders. We've got gear drives. We've got drives for the distributor. We've got water pump vanes and internals and impellers. They really, really get into details on this. The pistons are lovely. They're kind of rounded off at the top with their piston ring indicators on there. They snap together. All you really need to build this model kit is a side nipper and a screwdriver that they provide. We got the fan here and 3 AA batteries, and that is it. We got our counterweights, that awesome fan, front and back, great detail on there. Now you can paint some parts of this kit, which we're going to do here, or you can build it right out of the box and it's fine. Excuse me. We got our beautiful valve assembly here. That's all a press fit. Different valves for different areas. We got lifters. Obviously, this is an older style engine. You've seen the other kind of engines that I've built before, and I love doing them. Here's our connecting rods, the bottoms of the connecting rods, the caps down there, and our rocker arms. Beautiful scale proportions. The awesome detail on this kit never stops. I think it's the most highly detailed plastic model V8 ever I've ever seen. We've got our air cleaner here with filament. Now, if you want to paint that up, you go right ahead, and I am going to, so we'll talk about that in a moment. We got so many plastic parts over here that I move one, and we got a bunch that are going to fall. So here we go. And they are nice and durable. You don't have to worry about cracking those. The size of that oil pan, that is so big. And it's got these coming out of it so it can sit on the base properly for you. But that is spectacular. Looks just like the real thing. Huge. We got our cylinder heads. I like this vinyl style plastic, this clear styrene. That is awesome. Excellent detail on all of those. Here we've got our intake. Brought down nicely detailed. We've got our valve covers. Those look great. It's even got the holes for the plug holders that we showed you before, the plug wire guides. We've got our block. Check that out. That is a huge piece of molded plastic. You won't need to have any glue. You won't need to worry about any of that. This could be built over a weekend with parents and their kids, or if your kid has any ability to use a screwdriver, they can do this by themselves pretty easily. I would recommend it for probably ages 10 and up, kids that have assembled something before, and any adult on the planet. Moving to the other side of the table, we have a lot of interesting stuff over here. So let's just get it out here, and then we'll just go through it all. We got a big bag of screws. We'll toss that back on the side. Those are all the screws you'll be using to assemble it. And thankfully, they are all, it looks like, the same size. So there's no wondering, is this screw, is that screw? They even give you a little screwdriver. I'll be using my own, but they do give you that nice little screwdriver. We have a steel rod. Obviously, that is for the camshaft, where all those lobes will be fitting on in a certain order, and the manual shows you how. We've got an awesome base with sound, and the engine will spin when we're done. That requires three AA batteries. We'll get to all that in a little bit, but that's how it'll sit on that nice base. And we've got a front nameplate here, which is included in two languages, German and English. Nice metallic looking. That is very nice. We've even got cylinder head gaskets made out of cardboard so that you can know to put the gaskets in there and line those up, so you'll actually see them sandwiched in there like the real thing. We've got a small bag of gear drives that I didn't want to take out. I didn't want to lose any of them, but that's just a small bag of gears to make things work on the motor. We're going to see it when we build it. A beautiful, real looking distributor cap with wires, plug boots, and light up spark plugs. And of course, this plugs into the power base unit, and that acts as a coil wire coming off the side. So that's super detailed. Can't wait to get into that. That looks awesome. That looks better than a lot of the ones I've seen. Real flexible belts, not super tight belts that aren't going to go anywhere. And we've got a secondary belt here, flexible, should work fine. We've got our main drive belt, our fan belt, and all that right there. I love that it's flexible. They actually want you to use it. We've got all of our valve springs here, which they geniusly put on a zip tie, so you can cut one end loose and slide them off as needed. They don't show up pre-tangled in a bag and all beat up. For your money, they really give you a lot here. We've got the drive system with the big gear. That will drive the whole engine. That plugs into the power base, bolts onto the back of the motor, I'm sure, and that will give you your drive line. And then we've got our nice mic plug-in style, so you don't have to worry about hooking up wires. And we've got our exhaust manifolds. Last but not least, they're actually made in two pieces, but mine arrived all snapped together. So we're going to be doing that. Now, on my model kit, I am going to be painting some of this stuff. I want it to look a little more realistic. I'm going to be painting the fuel pump, the oil pan, and the air cleaner on mine. So what we're going to do now before I start any assembly is I'm going to go over and start painting things, and you can join with me. Thank you. Once you get that cool paint job on the parts, if you choose to paint them, I like it. It comes out real nice on there, that metallic color. We got the chrome on the air cleaner, the black on the oil pan. Then we'll start assembling in the manual they want us to assemble the pistons and the piston pins and the connecting rods. So we'll go together, we'll push everything together. What I like to do is in kits like this, I will cut all the parts free in each step. Since it's not a glue kit, it's an assembly kit. With screws and everything, we'll cut all the parts that we need free and put them in separate bins, and then I will start to push those together. These particular parts don't require screws just yet until we attach them to the crankshaft. So you take your piston pin, you take one of your pistons that you've cut free, you put it on there, you take a male piston and a female piston, and you put your connecting rod in there, and then you line up all your holes, and it's a stiff, there you go. So push, you snap it together, and you're all set. Now you can take your hobby knife and clean up the burr that's left over from removing them from the tree, and you've got your piston and connecting rod assembly. You will do that 8 times over. What happened in my kit was I am missing 2 piston pins, and that kind of sucks. So what I did was, the piston pins are just like this. They don't have to be hollow, but this is what they look like off the tree, and I am missing 2 of those in my kit. I searched the bags, I searched the box. They obviously fell off the parts tree when they were being molded and were never replaced or checked when they were put in the box. So when you get yours, check those right away. Everything else seems to be here. They're a little small parts, but everything else seems to be in place. I did double check all my parts trees. So what we're gonna do is make our own piston pin. And how I did that was I found some sprue in the kit that's the same diameter. It's on the exact same tree that the pistons and the piston pins come from, so it's very handy. And I hacked off the ends. Then all I did was take the real piston pin, I cut off one end of the plastic flush, lined it up, turned it around, snapped off the other end, and I was all set. And you end up with a manufactured piston pin like so, which will replace the 2 that I lost and worked perfectly. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these all snapped together. Then they have us attach them to the crankshaft, which is just using the bottom caps and screwing them in place right down here. And then we're going to run 2 of our screws. I love using these little welding trays, these magnetic trays for parts, because then my screws can just sit there, and if I hit it and bang it, screws don't go flying all over the bench. Little handy tip from Chris, who builds a lot of models and kits. We're going to push those together once it's around the crankshaft, put our screws in there, and then we're all set. So we'll come back once that's positioned inside the block. Quick and easy assembly processes lead us to this point here, and the only thing I've had to do so far was replace those 2 piston pins. Everything else has been included like it should be, and I made sure to double check that, so hopefully we don't have any more issues. But you can see after that camshaft is assembled, and after the crankshaft and the pistons were put in, just like we showed you they would be going in, what they have you do after you put that camshaft down inside there is attach your gears, your timing gears, and then your timing belt or chain in the real, it's not going to be a chain in the model kit, but they have you put that belt on there. What this little cool little tool in here is it just slides in and out to these perfectly keyed holes. That is to make sure that your timing is aligned correctly for the rest of the build. So you will just be inserting that in there. It is in the parts trees, and what they say and next is to install the motor housing. Now the motor housing doesn't spin easily unless it's under power. We will then be removing this timing key and inserting our motor housing, and then they recommend not spinning the motor at all until you get the, you know, don't test it with your electric motor. You want to do all your testing beforehand. Then When you get the motor on, they say don't spin it again until you get the distributor assembled because the timing will get screwed up, obviously. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to get the motor on. We're going to get the back cover of the engine on and everything, or the front cover of the engine on and everything, and start assembling those parts. We will be back at the next step. So remember, use this timing key to line everything up with the crankshaft and the camshaft. There's only one way it can go, and all these gears can only be assembled one way onto the shafts. They are keyed. You can see the different keys for different assembly areas. Then the belt just easily slips over, and it's a nice flexible belt, unlike the last kit that we put together with that rock hard belt that made everything skip, and everything is nice and smooth. You can feel free before you time and line these up to spin your pistons and spin your camshaft. Make sure they spin free. Have a good time doing that. But once you line these up, do not turn anything anymore. Gently remove that. We'll insert our motor housing for the drive gear, and then we will button up this end of the engine and come back for another look-see. The very next step, they have you attach the painted oil pan. It would be gray when it comes out of the box, but I painted it black to the base with four screws. As you saw, we got that timing cover on there. I love this idea. It looks like they're going to turn the motor drive system into the alternator. And that is absolutely, it just fits in there perfectly. What an amazing design and a nice way to hide that system, because the alternator should have a wire coming out of it anyways. So that's all set. You can see how everything looks once it's all assembled on that base. This thing is an absolute monster. That's my hand. It's a huge 289. Nice looking engine. The very next step is they have you attach this part of the intake, the lower intake, the part of the valve train. They even have you install this gear and screw it together. That will mate up with the gear on the camshaft for all your distributor purposes as it comes up. And that presses in like so. And we've got six screws to attach that in. Once that is attached, they're going to have us start building the valve train. And I think for that one, we're going to do a slideshow so you can see a few more pictures of how that's going to go together. We'll be back. With the cylinder heads assembled, we're going to start assembling the upper end of the motor. Now, through the crankcase cover, we're going to be putting in our push rods, and those will touch the camshaft and move up and down as needed. So you'll do each side individually, because these things will be kind of hard to line up with the head, but it'll take a few seconds of lining everything up. They'll kind of be cattywampus in the beginning, but they'll line up perfectly at the end. On your push rods, you'll have detachment points from the sprue, there and there on each one. You'll just want to make sure that you take your hobby knife and scrape that off so that it doesn't catch inside the crank cover there when the cam goes around, so it can freely push the head. Now, we've got the correct head for the correct size. The manual will tell you exactly which number, 37 or the other number, will go on which side of the engine. We've got our gasket. Now, you don't have to use this gasket if you don't like the looks of it, but you can go ahead and put it on over the bolt areas where our screws are going to go in. Then we'll take our head, and this might take a little bit, but we're going to have to line up all the push rods with the holes in the back of the head, and we'll just keep going until we get them all in there. There we go, starting to nestle down. Make sure they're all in there. So I've got some that are misaligned. Then we have to align them with the upper part of the head so that they come out and touch the rocker arm. We'll go in, there we go. You'll feel them when they snap into place. And then the head will just snap down. It's a little tight on this side because of the alternator, the gear drive, but as you can see, it goes down beautifully. You'll run three screws into this side, then you'll go ahead and attach your valve cover, and you'll attach that with three screws as well, or four screws, three on the bottom, one on the top here. And that's how you've got your entire bank assembled on that side of the engine. So I'm gonna go ahead, get that all attached, get the other push rods dropped in to this side, get my gaskets on, get that all attached. We'll be back for a look because we're getting really far on the engine now. Here's where I'll make a quick suggestion to go against what the manual says. In the manual, they want you to attach the fan and then attach your accessory drive belt for your alternator, your fan and all that, your water pump. But what I recommend doing so that we don't, and this is a beautiful belt, by the way, compared to the Banggood kit, an excellent belt, super flexible, even has toothed grooves on the one side, just lovely. So what I recommend doing is the fan, of course, doesn't have a pulley on it. So what I want you to do is first, and this is going to go so easy without the fan in the way, we'll just stretch it right over, and there you go. And we don't have to worry about overstretching it when we do the fan. Then put your fan on, take your screw, and run it right on in. And that's it. These screws bottom out nice and quickly, and then you'll have that on there, and that will be securely assembled without a problem. We've got our lovely belt system on there, which I know will spin freely. We even got the little alternator spinning, which is our motor housing. Now, we're going to be attaching the distributor, and the distributor goes on super easy, like real ones kind of just drop in, but you can see here it is keyed to all the other drive accessories. And what we'll do is we have to remove that plastic part we put in place on that drive gear on the intake that I showed you. Then we will line up that key, we will drop that in, and we will position our distributor down, and we will place two screws. Then if you look on the distributor underneath, you can see little numbers down there. We're going to look at the manual and we're going to route these spark plug wires into their proper housings and come back for a look to see how that all is going to look on there. That looks awesome. That distributor can only go on one way, as you can see, and it says so in the manual. There's a longer tab on the passenger side than there is on the driver's side, so you'll never be able to screw that up. The spark plug wires and their boots just go in based on the numbers, follow the picture on the manuals, and those just snap in and out of place. And on the side, they kind of go in tight, but you want to make sure you snap them in there, and then they have the proper angles and everything. All that's left on this kit is to install the manifolds that I happen to paint. You don't have to paint yours, but I wanted some color on this kit. We're going to snap on our fuel pump on the side. We're going to insert our dipstick. Yep, I went for just a little bit of customization with a Ford blue dipstick, so I can put that in there, and that will be stuck in the proper location. I need to paint the filament on the air cleaner and snap that on, but we are ready to go. This thing is just so cool, so detailed, and it's just absolute wonderful. So I can't wait for you to see the whole thing from a distance. You get it all in one, but just look at the size of that so far compared to my hand. We've got our power wires plugged in. We're all ready to go. I've just got to snap these final parts on, and we will be back for that final. This thing is so awesome and big, the turntable can barely get it to spin. It is just a spectacular model. Goes together so nicely. We got our air cleaner on there. We got it assembled on its base. Check that out, that beautiful metallic decal. We got our power plugs in. We got our activation button. We got our speaker. You can see painting up those manifolds really set them apart from the plug boots and the other silver plastic. The alternator looks great as the gear motor that spins everything. We've got our air cleaner up top looking awesome. I painted that in with just craft paints. Pick a color that resembles a filter element and go ahead and paint it in. So everything's going to look great. We got our aluminum fuel pump on there, aluminum colored fuel pump. We got our colored dipstick, which just slides in and out. It's such an awesome, awesome kit and super easy to assemble and works beautifully. Let me press that button back there. No weird noises, no anything misaligned. It all builds perfectly. The whole valve train works. The spark plugs light up in the correct areas. You can see awesome crank and pistons going up and down. It is just a spectacular engine, and it'll time itself out and turn itself off, and you can just turn it right back on. Just needs three AA batteries. Works beautifully. There'll be links in the description where you can pick these up online at numerous different places. I absolutely love it. It's definitely a much higher end. I'd say one of the highest, if not the highest, assembled model engines you could get out there. Just at how smooth it runs and how beautiful it works and how everything is perfect from the distributor through the valve train to the timing of the spark plug lights and how it all goes together. If you choose, put a little paint on it. Make it yours. Make it beautiful. And it is absolutely outstanding. We will raise Mr. Camera up so you can get a higher view of the engine then before the video is over. I will take some still shots, of course, for the end, but just press that button and around and around and around she goes. And then it will shut itself off. Or if you want to press the button and manually turn it off, you can do so. But just look at that. All the valves pop at the right time. It is absolutely lovely. So, pick this up. There'll be links in the description. We thank Franzis for sending this over for a full review, and we will see you at the next review.